Hello everyone, today I will discuss about mutual divorce or mutual consent divorce. So basically, divorce is definitely a very big step of someone's life. It has quite life-reaching pain situations or like has emotional attachment also to it. But it is better to sever this tie with mutual understanding without causing more pain to both the parties. Both husband and wife can sort out the issues and take the divorce without causing more trouble to each other. Both will be happy in that scenario, and that is why the mutual consent or the mutual consent divorce is important and comes into the place. So basically, mutual divorce is simpler, it is faster, it is cheaper, and it costs very less pain to both husband and wife and also their parents and families. So once the parties are both husband and wife are agree to give the divorce with mutual understanding without causing the pain to each other and without fighting, then that divorce is called mutual divorce or mutual consent divorce. So in case of mutual divorce, basically all the issues related to the alimony, maintenance, child custody, if there is any child, the properties are decided by both the husband and wife sitting together. They can take the help of the lawyer and lawyers for that decision. All those conditions are written down and submitted in the court for the mutual divorce. But there are several conditions for the mutual divorce. And so first one is, there should be, the divorce can be filed only after 1 year of marriage. So it is not like that after 2 months of the marriage or even after 6 months of the marriage, you just go to the lawyer and ask for that, okay, we want to take divorce, please help us. No, it doesn't happen like that. The minimum duration of which you can file the mutual divorce case is 1 year after the marriage. This is the mandatory period, and if any case is filed before that, it will be rejected then and there itself. The other condition is, there should be minimum of 1 year separation between the husband and wife. So that is why minimum 1 year of marriage is required, so that the condition of separate living of 1 year can be fulfilled by that condition. Also, during the period of separation, they should not be living, or they should not be able to live as a husband and wife. This is the important criteria for that. They can even live in the same roof, in the same house, but not like a husband and wife. And the third condition is, they should both agree to take this divorce with mutual understanding without any pressure from anybody else. So in which court where we can file this mutual divorce is, there are three places for that. Basically, first place is where the marriage was solemnized or where the marriage was performed. So that particular place, in that particular place court, you can file the mutual divorce petition. The second place is where the husband and wife was last residing together after the marriage as husband and wife. So basically, after the marriage, they move to the wife moves to the husband city. If it is different from the place of marriage, then that particular city where they lived together as a husband and wife, that place also the divorce petition can be filed. And the third place is where the wife is currently residing, at that particular place the mutual divorce petition can be filed in that place also. The complete process for mutual divorce is, first, both husband and wife have to consult a lawyer. They can either take help of only single lawyer, or they can take help of two separate lawyers also if they don't trust each other, or that they feel that their lawyer can take their interest in mind while doing the consultation. So this is the first important point, because the petition which will be filed is very important. So the drafting of petition of mutual divorce is the most important thing of this whole mutual consent divorce. So after that, the petition will be filed in the court, and that particular filing on the first date is called first motion. You will keep hearing first motion, second motion. That's why I am describing this, that the first date on which the both husband and wife appear in the court and submit the application is called first motion filing. The court takes the petition into record after getting the documents, verifying the documents, and even court can ask questions to both husband and wife. And after that, the case is taken to the record, and the court will grant the second motion date. This second motion date is after 6 months. Usually court always gives 6 months, and this particular 6 months is called cooling off period. This period can be extended up to 18 months also, and it can be reduced to 1 month also in certain cases where there is some urgency between the husband or wife to take the divorce quickly. That we'll discuss later. So after the 6 months, both husband and wife has to appear in the court again, and on this day this appearance is called second motion. And on the second motion, the court will, the judge will again ask that, and they have, the both husband and wife have to give consent confirmation that yes, they want to take the divorce. And based on this particular confirmation on second motion, the judge will grant the divorce, and the decree of mutual consent divorce will be awarded. I already explained that what is first motion and what is second motion. Is that first motion is when the case is filed by both husband and wife by going to the court together, and second motion is when they again go to the court and give the reconfirmation to take the divorce. However, in between the first motion and second motion is a 6 months cooling off period, and in this particular time, either of the husband or the wife can withdraw their consent, or they can choose not to give the consent on second motion, and then the court cannot grant the mutual divorce. So the mutual consent of both husband and wife on two times is mandatory for mutual divorce. What is this cooling off period? So basically, this cooling off period is 6 month time between the first motion and the second motion, which is given by the court to save the marriage. So basically, what happens is sometimes there are issues, there are some misunderstanding, miscommunication, there's some like child is not happening or whatever reasons, their husband and wife go for the divorce, and in these 6 months the situations can change, and then there may be they can withdraw the mutual divorce also. So basically the court intention is to give this 6 months period so that the both husband and wife can sit together and think over their decision of divorce with cool mind. And if within the 6 months also, by counseling or by family and friends help, they're not able to together, then they can file the consent on the second motion to get the divorce. This cooling period can be waived off in certain exception situations, which depends on the case to case, and it's at the discretion of the court. What are the documents required for mutual consent divorce? So basically, the documents differ a little bit from the state to state, but more of the remain the same. The first is the ID and address proof for both the husband and wife, and then the marriage certificate. And if the marriage certificate is still not made, then the marriage invitation card is a must. Along with that, there should be a photographs of the marriage of both husband and wife, which shows that marriage was performed. Along with that, they should also bring their passport size photographs. Also, the court can ask for the evidence of that the both husband and wife are living separately. And also, if there has been any attempt of reconciliation or there is any counseling to save the marriage. Along with that, the income tax proof or the income proof of both husband and wife, and the details of their income and the current properties which they brought, the assets they have currently, and the liabilities if they have taken a joint loan, and the Stridhan, all these things also, those details has to be provided in the petition. So how many times like the husband and wife have to appear in the court is that they have to appear in the court 2 times together, and that is like on the first motion and the second motion, when like first motion and second motion is filed in the court. If they are not able to appear basically for any reasons which has to be like corroborated with any some evidence, then they can also ask their lawyer to help, or any family member can appear on behalf of them. But it is advisable to appear together both the times so that the divorce is granted without any issues and cannot be challenged later. Exactly how much time it takes to get the divorce, as like it earlier I said that that this is much faster than the contested divorce. So basically divorce can be granted in 1 month also if there is any emergency situation, and also it can be dragged up to 18 months maximum. But basically most of the cases are given the divorce in 6 months on the second motion date itself, if none of the party withdrew their consent, or there also no waiver of the cooling off period, then the entire duration of taking that mutual divorce is 6 months only. Exactly how many lawyers are required for mutual divorce is basically it can be done by taking the help of only single lawyer also, but it is advisable that you take help of two lawyers so that they can protect your interest. If not possible to have two separate lawyers for entire case, better take help of another lawyer for consultation for preparing the mutual divorce petition, because this is the most important document which will be submitted in the court. So it should be prepared with utmost care, and there the lawyer can help you a lot to protect you. The alimony and maintenance is decided, as I said earlier, all the issues are decided by husband and wife sitting together without the interference of the court. There is no fight over any issue in the court for any of the issues at all. So both husband and wife are responsible to sit together and decide on the alimony and maintenance of each other. This is the most difficult part obviously for any divorce, because maximum disagreements happen over this issue itself, even in the contested divorce also. Both husband and wife can take help of their lawyers to help them settle this matter also. Similarly, the issue of child custody is also solved by husband and wife together, and this is also important because children are the emotional bond between the husband and wife, or between husband and the child, or the wife and the child. But only husband and wife can take this decision by mutual understanding and mutual consent. Assets, the properties and any loans has to be solved by husband and wife only. But yes, they can definitely, and they usually take help of lawyers in these particular things. And this is also very important, since this is money matters, and also it can create issues later after the divorce as well. So like in case there is a joint loan, and after the divorce only one party will be paying for it, who is having the possession of that particular property. But if the joint name is there, then the bank can ask and reach the door of the second party as well. And the same is for the any property which is in the joint name. So the joint name has to be removed, because then it cannot be sold easily after the divorce, because then both the parties are the joint owners, and then it will create issue while selling. Yes, any of the party can withdraw the consent any time after the first motion and before the second motion, or they can also choose not to appear on the second motion and give the consent of severing the tie of marriage and give the divorce. And this happens in many cases as well, and that is why it is important to mention each and every detail and each and every aspect of the petition by taking the help of the lawyers, so that they can be protected when the second party withdraws their consent. Once the party withdraws the consent or does not appear for the second motion to confirm the consent, then the mutual divorce cannot be granted. Option remains to go for the contested divorce. Yes, there has to be very careful. You have to be very careful while the mutual divorce petition is drafted, because those clauses are very, very important. Once the mutual divorce is granted, then it is binding and it is cannot be challenged very easily in any court. So if you over promised or you promised by mistake or promised something only to take divorce, then it is not a good idea. If there is any alimony is being given to wife, then that has to be mentioned in the petition. And basically whatever money is given on the first motion, whatever the money is given on the second motion has to be mentioned, and all these monies are recorded in the court proceedings also, because all the everything is given in the court itself, in the within the court, by using the DD, and all those details are recorded in the court proceeding. Yes, only after 90 days. Basically, any husband or wife can appeal for the mutual consent divorce within the 90 days, and if it is appealed, then the divorce decree is not final. But if appeal is not filed, then after 90 days the decree becomes final and you can remarry after that. Yes, the divorce case can be transferred to the another city. Basically, like if the wife moves to another city for job or any situation, or like both husband and wife move to another city, then they can make a request on to the Supreme Court. But it is advisable that you go to the city where the first motion was filed, and you have to appear only this one more time on the second motion, and the decree can be awarded on that particular day. The divorce for NRIs is more or less remain the same, but exception can be granted for maybe in camera proceedings, or court can also extend the cooling off period up to 18 months to wait for the party to return to India for the second motion confirmation. Currently also the NRI's marriages are in limelight, because many people are now marrying girls in India and then they leave to the foreign country, they return back there by leaving the wife in India itself. And in those cases, wife doesn't have much options available to her, and the only thing that she can file for the ex parte divorce. You can also file the mutual divorce decree in the foreign country also where they are living, but it has to be according to as per the Indian laws. Otherwise, it can be challenged in Indian courts.